What is up, Boston Steel Scarf fans, and welcome to our PGL Week 4 matchup against Carson, aka Toxic Gaming, and the Chicago Bewares. Pretty intense matchup today. He brought sort of different than what I had expected, but we're looking pretty good to lead Dawn Fan here this game. Only problem would be the Tapu Lele lead or the Vaporeon. Odds of those being the lead, and not too great. It's potential that he will predict the Banjo, though. It is a possibility. So, let's do it. Banjo it is, going into the lead. We're shaking off last week's loss. It was a terrible, awful loss. Should not have happened. We had the win. Our Pokemon somehow got outsped. I must have did something wrong when getting the Latios in the game. And yeah, it was unfortunate, but this week we're gonna try and shake it off. We got the same exact team with some different stats, of course, different move sets, but more or less the same items. Besides Air Balloon on Heatran is now Assault Vest, so we can live from Tapu Lele if need be. So yeah, we're looking all right for this matchup. I'm not super confident. Last week I was pretty much, I wasn't that confident, but in the middle of the game, I really thought we had it. Week 2, I was really confident. We ended up winning that game. So this game, I'm going into it not knowing what to expect. This is our first time ever battling Carson, so I don't know what kind of battler he is, but he does lead with his gosh darn Tapu Lele, which is rather unfortunate for us. Dawnfan, let's check Dawnfan going up against this thing. Dawnfan versus Lele. Tapu Lele. Let's see if his choice Specs Psychic does kill us. He's not Specs, and he is Scarf. It still kills. Well, we have Sturdy. How much does Gunk Shot do? Gunk Shot might just be worth it. It's actually worth it. It's actually worth it if he doesn't have any defensive investment. I don't know if I'm ready to do that, though. What comes into this thing on our team? Let's check. We got 60 seconds to decide. We can bring in Molotov. That's kind of our check. Molotov. I want to see. No, I almost typed in Molotov. Heatran. I do want to see what we're doing here. I mean, obviously, we're going to kill this thing with Heatran, but if we come in on a Focus Blast, it's not going to be that great for us. He'll outspeed. So I'm waiting for him to maybe make the prediction, and I'm gonna go, this is gonna be crazy, but I'm gonna go for the Gunk Shot. I think it's kind of silly, but whatever. We're okay. He does play the safe move and go for Psychic. That's kind of a bummer. He's not Specs. He is not Specs, and he is dead, which is great for us. Get that out of the way right away. It's gonna be bad in the sense that now our Dawnfan's very low, but it's all right. It's all right. All right, let's add Tyranitar to this. Tyranitar. Right, he has Tyranitar. I'm not crazy. Yeah, he has Tyranitar. He also, I can get rid of a few things. Doesn't, what does he not have? Doesn't have the Infernape, right? I don't think. It's kind of a shame if he doesn't, because I definitely could have brought our Ferrothorn, which I was thinking about bringing. I'm not going to remove anything until I see a list of his team again, though. Alright. Whew! Shake off some nerves. Let's really quickly just check his team. He's Kamala, Excadrill, Tyranitar, Charizard. So he has Charizard X instead of Infernape. Charizard X. Now, getting the rocks up would be really nice, but I think it's best we do something else instead. Alright, so who comes in on this thing? Who do we have for this? Oh man, actually not too much. I guess Hitmontop actually can take fairly well I don't want to switch on an ice beam. Let's see. Latios. Yeah, Latios doesn't want to take an ice beam. I think we let Donphan go down here. Goes for a water move, though. We're so safe to go into something else. It's just ice beam kills. Ice beam hits a lot of things, so I don't know why he wouldn't go for ice beam. Let's make a decision quick here. All right, before I do that, let's just check Hitmontop, what moves he's got. I kind of forgot. Toxic, Okay, yeah. We're going to go into Hitmontop. I know it sounds crazy, but I think it might be just crazy enough to work. Might just be crazy enough to work here. He does go for the ice beam, so that's great. We should eat this fairly well. Oh, we're not assault vested though, and I put assault vest on here on my sheets. I think my sheets got deleted and reset actually from last week, so that's not good, but we'll work with it. This turn we can actually go for a toxic. If he scalds and burns us, it will be an issue. It will definitely be an issue. Am I ready to take a scald burn? I'm not ready to take a scald burn. Need you for the Tyranitar. You really do. Okay. So you know what? I'm gonna risk it. I'm feeling risky today. I'm feeling so risky today. I don't know what has come over me. I'm shaky, but I'm feeling risky. I'm hoping something strange goes on here. Maybe he goes for another ice beam, hoping for me to switch again, pull a double switch. That would be ideal, unless he freezes us. Please don't do it now that I said it. But we went for a Toxic, so if he switches something in on the Toxic, that would be good, besides the Excadrill. He does go through the Ice Beam. Very nice, very nice. Alright, we are unfortunately very low HP now, but we do manage to get off the Toxic on this thing. And I don't believe he has any Rain on his team, so... I mean, that's a Vaporeon. Not looking too great. We do need this Hitmontop for later, so I would love to get rocks up, but I can't. I just can't. So, best move, we can expect Scald, or we can go, who takes the Ice Beam better? Latios takes it better, but he doesn't really dish out quite as much damage. We could sack off Donphan and just not get rocks up. What do we have for his Charizard? Not really much. We have Mimikyu. So there's that. Alright, so let's see. We go Scald. All right, you know what? Not getting rocks up will really stink, but let's just do it. Let's just sack him off. Not what I wanted, but oh, he switches into Charizard as we go into Donphan. Okay. Okie dokie. Charizard, definitely gonna kill Banjo. Unless he goes for a Dragon Dance, of course. In which case, I mean, we can go for an Earthquake. Because he has to Mega Evolve turn one. So what if he goes for a Dragon Dance? What if he does? So I think Earthquake, we just gotta kinda man up and do it. Let's see him go for a DD. Because we do some good damage with an EQ would be nice. I could have Ice Shard. He never knows. He never knows. He would never know. He would never know. No. All right. Plus, I have Stone Edge on Hitmontop, although I'm not going to outspeed this Charizard. And we are kind of low. We are kind of low. So, maybe... Oh man, this Charizard's going to be more trouble than I thought. We have Heatran, who has Earth Power. Could do quite a bit of damage to this Charizard, if need be. And we also don't really need Molotov anymore, because we took out the Tapu Lele turn one, which is cool. It's very cool. Communicating, please stand by. Okay, so there he goes. He's got to pop that. That's the rules. Let's just hope he goes for a Dragon Dance. I know that's weird to say, let's hope he goes for a Dragon Dance, but let's just hope he goes for a Dragon Dance. Let's hope he goes for a Dragon Dance. He does go for a Dragon Dance. Oh my god. Oh my god. As we're gonna go for the Earthquake. Boom. Oh my god, that must... Is that a crit? That was not even a crit. Woo! Banjo! Banjo, my man. Banjo, my man. My man, my man, my man. All right. Now I think we just sack off Banjo, unfortunately. I'm sorry, Banjo. You did some work. You did some work. We could go for a Roost. You never know. Expecting us to switch out. That would be so ideal that it's not even funny. There's no way that that happens. If it does, I will freak out. I will absolutely 110% freak out at the fact that he would go for Roost. But we'll see. We'll see what he decides to do. Like, oh, maybe he wants to save this for rocks later. Maybe. Maybe I do. Maybe I don't. I'm not going to tell you. I'm not going to tell you. I actually don't really care to get rocks up at this point now that his Charizard's already Mega Evolved. I mean, it would be nice, of course, but it's not a necessity anymore. He's going to go for Dragon Claw. Smart play. We are dying to that, of course. Of course. Donphan, you're dead. So, if we bring out Latios, we outspeed, we go for Psychic. It's everything except for his Tyranitar. What else do we have? We have Ice Beam, which would hit it wouldn't hit him for much. It'd still do something, but Ice Beam would definitely kill. Plus Shadow Ball. Shadow Ball might be better. Let's see what else we could go for. I mean, we could also bring in... No, he's got Dragon Dance, so... And outspeed. So we got to bring in Latios. Got to bring in Latios and go for a... Oh my god, we could go for Surf. We have Surf. We have Surf. We have Surf Latios. Oh boy. Right? We do have Surf Latios, right? I did bring Surf. What didn't I bring instead of Surf? Okay. Surf, Psychic, Thunderbolt, Shadow Ball. Surf, Psychic, Thunderbolt, Shadow Ball. I didn't bring Ice Beam. That's... Alright. So Surf... Definitely kills. We're gonna go for it. If he brings in his Vaporeon... his Vaporeon's not dead. If he brings on his Vaporeon, that's a great play. He doesn't. That's great. We're hitting Tyranitar for a lot. We're killing Charizard. We're hurting the Excadrill. We're not hurting the Thunderous too much, but... So, we're doing 40 damage, 40%. He is going to withdraw. Please don't be Vaporeon. Rude. That's the Tyranitar. Totally, perfectly okay with this. Going to do quite a number. So, here comes the Surf. And that thing is possibly Assault Vested. Possibly. It could just be run specially defensive, actually. Let me check. Yeah, he could just be running special defense investment. Just saying, learn pursuit. I gotta look this up really quick. This is his Tyranitar. And does Tyranitar learn Pursuit? It does learn Pursuit.
That'd be very unfortunate.
What are the odds? Crunch would hurt. I mean, a crunch would kill.
Shoot, okay. Do we think he's running Pursuit? I mean, I said it, so I almost feel like I have to stick with it. Because I said it. But I need this for the Charizard. I'm gonna switch.
Please don't be wrong. He does go for Pursuit. Shoot, we should have stayed and gone for Surf. Just stayed and gone for Surf. I don't even know if we would live even that. Actually, we probably would have. Cosplay can come in. Let's just look this up really quick. All right. So we got ourselves a Mimikyu. Battle spot, of course. And then Tyranitar. This thing is fat. Okay. So we're living a lot. We're living quite a bit of hits.
We could come in and dizzy it first, but I think we're going to bring in Cosplay.
Although, how much does Heatran do? Heatran is doing 80 some odd percent. How fast is a Tyranitar? How fast is a T-tar? 61.
He doesn't have speed investment on this thing, right? Why would he? Why would he?
Go for a flash cannon. It hits a lot, I would assume. Not really, but
all right, let's switch. I'm gonna switch in the Molotov.
I think he'll go into Vaporeon. Whoa, what is going on here? Latios is dead, unfortunately.
Okay. Ooh, this might not kill if he's especially defensive.
We made up our mind, we're doing it. We're doing it. Let's see if he goes into Vaporeon or not. Deciding if I have the Grassium Z, maybe. He's thinking I might have Grassium Z for that Vaporeon, hopefully. That's his thought process here. That'd be very nice. He's gonna bring in something. He is gonna withdraw. I think that was his Vaporeon. It is his Vaporeon. And really quickly, it's buffeted by the sandstorm. It's also going to take that toxic damage. All right. And I really quickly want to look at his team one more time. He does not have the Cofagrigus. I was thinking that he did. I'm glad I looked that up. He does not have that. He has the Komala. All right. Now, a good switch in here. There's not too much. I could outspeed this thing.
Let me check what moves I have. Don't have anything to hit this. Okay.
I bring in Cosplay.
I set up a swords dance. Let's check this really quickly. Let's go Vaporeon. Level 50. How much am I doing? I'm not even killing that there. I guess with the swords dance I would. Let's hope he doesn't try and get a wish off. He's gonna use Scald. Hopefully he doesn't catch a burn. Disguise breaks. Okay. He might be in range to not even have to set up a Swords Dance. Definitely after the turn. But this might be our best chance if he wants to set up a Wish. Or something. Oh, we do have Woodhammer. I completely forgot we had Woodhammer. I forgot we had Woodhammer. Oh my god. Let's go for Woodhammer. I want to go for Woodhammer in case he's like, oh, I'm going to bring in my Excadrill. And then we can just destroy that thing with a Woodhammer. That would be, let's check, Excadrill. He's definitely a Sand Rush, I believe. Let's see Woodhammer really quick. I didn't bring Shadow Sneak because he had Tapu Lele. I'm going to go for a Woodhammer. We outspeed this thing, so... Wait, we don't outspeed this thing? Scarfed? He's a fudging scarfed Vaporeon. He's a scarfed Vaporeon. That's weird. That's weird. Scarfed Vaporeon. Okay. Unless something weird happened again this week, which it shouldn't have, I quadruple checked everything before starting this match. So if something's awry again, I'm just utterly dumbfounded. Utterly dumbfounded. So that's not good. Oh, we have a Lumberry if we had gotten burned. Forgotten about that. Alright, so we got that thing dead. I mean, still not great. Really hoping for the Excadrill switch in would have been so nice, or even the Tyranitar would have been good. Good. I know we're playing a little bit daring today. I don't know, kind of just wanting to get the match over with. But we're looking all right. Looking all right. If I was him, I'd probably bring in my Excadrill. Log. That is his Kumala. And let's check this Kumala out. Kumala. Okay, he shouldn't outspeed unless my speed got screwed up. Or he's Choice Scarf as well. Assuming this thing's like some sort of weird defensive, possibly. I think he was running Choice Band a few weeks ago, though. I'm not even touching this thing. Oh, wait, no. Hold on. I don't even know what kind of moves Kamala gets. Didn't really think he'd bring it, which is probably why he brought it. He does get Woodhammer, he gets U-turn. Swords Dance, Sucker Punch, Acrobatics, Quick Break. It's more of a physical attacker. Normal type, right? We'll bring in Dizzy. I'm hoping he doesn't have anything for Dizzy. We're gonna switch into Dizzy. Oh, guys, I wanted to say this at the beginning of the game, but I was so nervous and anxious that I forgot. I made a few trades this week for next week's battle. We dropped Incineroar, unfortunately, Libre. We dropped for our good old friend Umbreon. He's going to set up a wish, probably send it to Charizard. But we do have Rock Slide, so there's that. So Umbreon for Incineroar, or Incineroar for Umbreon, and we also traded away Toxapex for Araquanid. Toxapex just didn't work in any matchup for some reason. It's such a beast of a tank, but everybody had, like, you know, there's Tapu Lele, and then there's, like, these hard-hitting guard chomps with Earthquake and all these things that just destroyed Toxapex, so I kind of had to kind of give it up there. I could totally set up a Toxic on maybe his Charizard. I'm going to go for the Toxic, expecting Charizard. And if he just stays in with Log here... Oh, wait. I can't poison this thing, right? Because of Comatose? That's right. I can't Toxic this thing because of Comatose. So let's hope that he switches into his Charizard. If he does, we're hitting that thing with the Toxic, which is great. If not, we're going to have to figure out something funky. Funky fresh. Let's hope he doesn't come in with Excadrill either, because Excadrill can't get Toxic. I wouldn't mind him coming into his whatchamacallit there. He does go for Protect. He's going to Scout. Alright, so this turn, he's either going to go Extra Girl, seeing that, well, he's got to go Wish one more turn. He's got to Wish one more turn if he wants to do anything. Right? No, because it doesn't come down until this turn. Alright, so... he sees the Toxic. I think I'm going to go for a Stone Edge. Just really hoping for the Charizard here, because I don't want to reveal we have Stone Edge. Oh, he stays in. He's going to go for Wish. I don't think he'll bring in his Charizard on this. After seeing that, I don't think he'll bring in his Charizard, so... we can go for a close combat, I think. He's just going to protect. We can get ahead of him. And it's protecting. We can go into Molotov. We could go into Cosplay, set up a Swords Dance. Sinbad. What does this thing do to Sinbad? I don't really know this thing's moves. That's my biggest issue. I could just switch this turn. No, he's not going to protect again, right? I'm going to go for a Stone Edge again. He does use Protect. Here comes his Wish. Okay. We're just going to get some leftovers. That's fine. That's fine by me. Let's go for the close combat. If he switches in his Charizard, that's great. But he wants to wish it. So I'm just going to go for the close combat at this point. I mean, he has plenty of counters to this, but he's probably fearing a Stone Edge. So the only thing he'd come into is his Excadrill. I don't think he's going to do that. We do take out Log, which is great. Okay. Another one bites the dust. Now he's wondering, is our last move Rapid Spin or Mach Punch for that Tyranitar? But we have pretty much full HP again, which is really good. I always touch my face way too much in battles. I get nervous, I get anxious, and I touch my face. That's what I do.
Very, very annoying, I know. But we're going to see what he comes into. Comes into Joey Wheeler, which is his Charizard. Which... Which? What does Charizard learn? Does Charizard learn any air moves? Flying moves? Let's look it up. Let's bring a Charizard onto these sheets. Charizard X, do you learn flying moves? You do learn flying moves. You learn acrobatics. That might hurt. Acrobatics, aerial ace, air slash, fly, sky drop. We'll just put an aerial ace for now, whatever. Let's see how much it does. Doesn't even do as much. Okay. You know what? Stone Edge. We're gonna try it. I don't know what he could have. I don't think he'll knock us out with anything. I would have preferred to get the Intimidate, but... What can you do? Flare Blitz will kill him. Kill himself. I just don't see what he could do. He's going to use Earthquake. Should be able to eat that pretty well, I would think. And we're going to go for the Stone Edge. It connects and gets the kill on Wheeler here. Joey Wheeler. I don't know. I'm assuming because that's Red Eyes, maybe. Red Eyes, Black Dragon. That's why it's Wheeler. It could be a completely different reason, but... Okay. We're looking all right. He does have Tyranitar. He also has Excadrill. Excadrill, we're going to have to buy out turns. Here's Darude Sandstorm over here. I think we can live an Earthquake from this. And I don't want to switch out on a Pursuit again. Though I don't think it'll be the biggest issue in the world. Didn't go for the close combat. Staying in, going for the close combat. We have Focus Blast on our Thundurus. I don't like relying on Thunder or Focus Blast, but it's there just in case. It's there. I would love to get a win this week, but I don't want to jinx it. We've had plenty of times where things have gone gone completely wrong. He could kill us this turn. He could have a move that I'm not thinking of. Zen Headbutt, maybe. I don't know if Tyranitar gets that, but possibility. I don't know. Sea Psychic. No, doesn't get anything like that. I'm trying to think what else. It does get Blizzard, Aqua Tail. Aqua Tail wouldn't kill. I don't know why I just said that. And neither would Blizzard. I'm just saying things now to say them. I realize that. I say a lot of weird things when I'm battling. It things that, like, if I took maybe one extra second to think about, I wouldn't sound as stupid half the time, but what can you do, you know? What can you do? Here we are, though. We're waiting. We're communicating. Please stand by. And he's gonna go for Thunder Punch. I think we can live this. Oh my god, barely. Here comes the close combat. He does have a berry, which might make him live. Oh, he barely lives. We bought a turn. We bought a turn. Hey, I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. I think... Let's see. Cosplay... We don't outspeed Excadrill. Cosplay does. Without the sand up. I think we let Dizzy go down. I mean, we don't outspeed anything left.
So let's just go for a close combat.
Let's just go for the close combat. Who knows?
Nope, he's just gonna rock slide and destroy our lives.
If I talk into this, it echoes.
All right, there goes Dizzy. Wasted another turn of the sand. And out can come... let's see. Sinbad could come out and go for... anything. Thunderbolt kills. We wouldn't want to go for that, though. That would be silly. Dark Pulse kills, even though it doesn't do that much. It's just that stupid Excadrill is the issue. Cosplay. Switch in cosplay. Alright, I have to really quickly calc if Shadow Claw will kill. I feel like there's potential that it won't. Tyranitar. Hazard Support. Shadow Claw. Yeah, Shadow Claw will kill. Who am I fooling? I'm gonna click it. Oh my god, I thought it lived! I hate Pokemon Sun and Moon. They always do that. Always have that tiny little thing left. So now he's forced to bring in Perfect 10. That's his Excadrill, who does outspeed us, but we're wasting a turn here. We are wasting a turn. How many turns is this sand going to be up for? I don't know. Number two. And it lasts for what, three turns or five? That might be enough for him to win, actually. Woodhammer, let's do it. Let's do it. Woodhammer it is. Woodhammer it is. Get a crit cosplay. I believe in you. I believe in you. You are better than Pikachu. Your costume is on point. You are the greatest Pokemon known to man. Cosplay. And you can get this crit. Oh, never mind. It outspeeds. I'm forgetting completely that it outspeeds with Sand Rush. As long as it is actually Sand Rush, which I don't know why it wouldn't be, since the sand is up. So it outspeeds. So I don't know if he's thinking maybe I'm switching to Landorus or something. So he's going to set up a Swords Dance, wasting yet another turn of the sand. And that does a little less than 50. We're going to be damaged by the recoil. That was dumb. I forgot Woodhammer had a recoil. Or is that Rocky Helmet or something? No, he has leftovers. Okay. What is a better chance of killing the other Thunderous? My Thunderous has a better chance. So, Molotov, let's waste this sand if we can. I think this is the last turn of sand. I really hope so. All right, let's just do it. Lava Plume. Here we go. Maybe some miracle, we somehow live. This thing's got a Swords Dance up. My god. I mean, Earthquake does 200% without Swords Dance, so... Not happening. Don't get greedy and go for another Swords Dance. Sandstorm turn one? What? How did it get reset?
They get how? What?
That's lying. Sandstorm, turn number one.
What?
I hope that that's just something weird. It's just talking about how long Molotov's been here with Sandstorm. There's no way Sandstorm's been here for only one turn. All right, we're having some connection issues. He did warn me that his internet is a little spotty right now. So, gonna use the earthquake. Let's hope that Sandstorm subsides. If not, good game to him. Sandstorm does subside. Fantastic. I don't know. Okay. It comes down to a focus blast. This thing's not Scarf. That would be silly. No, he has Sword Stance. Okay. I'm being silly. Focus Blast. You've got to hit this, Sinbad. You've got to hit this, my friend. You've got to hit this. Or he can switch out. That's fine, too. He can switch out. All's good. I believe, Sinbad. Everybody type, I believe in you, Sinbad. In the chat, in the comment section. Sinbad, you can pull through here, buddy. You can do this. I would actually prefer you switch out because we get a little bit of chip damage off on Thundurus and then we can guarantee an Oko Thunderbolt. Thunderbolt is a roll on his Thundurus to get the kill. So he doesn't though. Oh, he does avoid the attack. He goes for Shadow Claw. That secures his win because he outspeeds with his Thundurus. Good game. Good game. Sinbad, I believed, but oh, so close. It was so close. Oh, he defeated him? What? He didn't bring a Thundurus. What am I thinking? Guys, I'm so dopey because I still had Thundurus on my sheet. So what it is, sure, I'll save it just in case. Can't believe we missed that though. Anyways, I was just typing in. anyways, he says it just had to come down to hacks for him to win, which, oh my god, we're so lucky that did not happen this week. But what I was going to say is I used a calculator, sweeper calc, and in it, I can only put mons from Gen 1 to 6 in it. So all the new mons aren't on here yet. And so I have placeholders like Thundurus, so just other mods that I think they might bring that aren't from Gen 7. So if they bring a Gen 7 mod, a lot of times I forget to delete it off of that sheet. So then I look over and I'm like, oh my god, he still has Thundurus. So that was my bad, but we actually secured a victory today, which is great. So we had plus one differential and we're 2-2. Pretty good so far. I mean, we can definitely turn the season around, keep it going at this pace. Next week, we do have some new mods on the team that I think are really going to help. I've been struggling, guys. I've been struggling to find specially defensive mods on the team because that's supposed to be like Toxapex's role. But like I said, Tapu Lele's, just all these crazy psychic and ground types are in the league this season. It's probably because I took Toxapex round one. They're all like, oh, we need a counter to Toxapex. So they all took psychic and ground types that just destroy it. I had to trade it away. And I think next week we're going to have some new mons to work with. This will be so much better. And then the week after that, I'm thinking I'm going to try and do some more trades again and get our team you know, moving around a little bit again, because I have some ideas and we'll have to wait and see how they work out. But thank you guys so much for checking out this video. If you guys didn't enjoy, please shield bash the like button down below. I appreciate the support. Sorry that I am such a bimbo, and yes, I'm a bimbo, and forgot that he only had that mon left. So thank you all for watching. See you in the next one. Till then, stay frosty and peace out.